Hello, my name is Andrei Ignat. I am a C# MVP, and in this video I'll show you one of my favorite tools. Today I want to talk about a feature of C# async await. This is good for having multiple tasks running parallel. Think about reading an HTML file or multiple HTML files, obtaining results from database and so on. What I want to show you is how to modify your code in order to use async await and tasks. And the second, the pitfalls that are in this transformation. So we have here a class that writes to file here and read from console there. And it is a two task that calls both tasks, but first it's write to file, then it read console. So it may be useful, not for this application, but in general, in order to execute the two tasks in parallel. So let's see how the application works first. In the main program, we have two tasks and read key, and let's see in work. AA so returns true because he could read the file and read the console and write the file. Okay, so let's transform those in async await. I first wrote here task bool write to file async task bool read console. And I want to see if the write could be made async. And here it is, write async. And we modify write async and we put await. And we see if read line could be made async with this. And it put await. Sorry. Okay, now write to file, it isn't return a bool, it is returning a task of bool, so we must await for this. Await and await. And the same here, it should be async task bool. And now here it's not a problem. However, in the main program, we have two tasks. And we do not can put result because it's static and void and could not put async and it we are putting dot result. We compile. We are running. We put AAA and it's same the result. What's the catch? Because it was too simple. The catch is those are not executing in parallel. So if I put here task dot delay and console.write line write to file. And I've put here read from console. The read from console should be in parallel with this kind of with the write to file, but let's see what it happens and then I will explain why. So I have write to file, read from console, AAA and true. So it was not a read from console, it was write to file, the first one. Let's see again. Why is this? Because awaits for this write to file. Await read console awaits for read the console. They are not executing in parallel. To execute in parallel, the easiest way is to make a list of task of bool because it returns bool. Return list equal. Okay, and I put var because I like more var than definition. I said file, it's write to file, console, it's read console, and I put await task dot when all file console. Let get rid of return list. This is the if you want, if you have a not known number of task. So I have await task call and return file dot result and console dot result. So now I have been waiting to first have read from console and then write to file. Let's see. Let's put bigger and put await. Read from console and then it's writing to file. Read from file after 12 seconds. This concludes our demonstration, and I think that I show you how to modify very easily from synchronous to asynchronous, and just be conscious that await must be put in, you must await for all or for any, and not just executing in parallel with await. Thank you.